On the 12th of January 2010, the Caribbean nation of Haiti was devastated by a magnitude 7 earthquake. Haiti lies on the boundary between the Caribbean and North American plates. The 2010 earthquake occurred on the Enriquillo-Plantain Garden Fault. This fault is a conservative plate margin, which means the plates move alongside each other. The fault had been locked in tension for 250 years, and all this energy being released caused a massive earthquake. The earthquake occurred at 4:53 p.m. local time, 25 kilometers west from the capital city, Port-au-Prince, with its focus being just 13 kilometers below the surface. As you can imagine, it had devastating effects. The primary impacts include 30,000 commercial buildings collapsing, over 230,000 deaths and 300,000 injuries, over 100,000 houses were destroyed, many hospitals were destroyed, and so was the presidential palace, and the main port was also destroyed. Secondary impacts include over 2 million people being left homeless and without food or water, and an increase in crime, with many shops being looted. The immediate responses include 2.6 million bottles of water being donated by the United States, temporary hospitals were set up by the Red Cross, and 500 UN troops and police were sent to help distribute aid and keep order, such as preventing looting of shops. The long-term responses include: the International Monetary Fund approved $102 million in assistance for rebuilding, 98% of the rubble was still uncleared after 6 months, and a year later there were still 1,300 camps housing 1.6 million people. As well as knowing some of the effects, it's important to understand why they were so devastating. With Haiti being a low-income country, it was not very well prepared. There were very few earthquake-resistant buildings, with many buildings and other structures being poorly built. There were also very few resources to rescue or help injured people, meaning it had to heavily rely on foreign aid.